everyone, my name is Amalia Urbino and I'm the Product Marketing Manager for Recurring Tasks here at Upscale. So what exactly is Recurring Task and how can it help you when you find yourself constantly having to manually create repetitive tasks to be reflected in your board? Well, our app helps exactly with just that. With one step, you can create all these repetitive tasks to be reflected in your board so you never miss anything important again. And not only that, you can also choose when you want that task to be reflected in your board. So let's get into the demo and I'll show you how it works. Let's go. Now I'm going to show you how you can create a recurring task using our app. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to select the item that you want to create the recurring task of. So as you can see, it's going to open the side view panel and our app lives above in the tabs of the side view panel. In order to add our app in, you're gonna go to add view, type in recurring and select add to item. And then once that's done, it's actually going to appear up here. So then you're gonna click on the tab and it's gonna open our app, which is gonna ask you for the first two settings. So the first thing you have is the start date, and the start date is actually going to take the date that's showing up in the date column. So in this case, the 4th of February, but you can go ahead and edit that as you see fit using our drop-down column. So it works like any other calendar. So I'm going to go ahead and, for example, change the date to the 11th of February, and then it's going to ask you repeats every. So how often do you want the task to repeat? In this case, for example, you have the option by day. You have the option by week, you have the option by month. In this case, you can select, you know, day 11 of the month or the second Monday or Wednesday of the month, highly customizable. And then you can also do it by year. And in this case, select, you know, the day, the month, or, you know, the second Tuesday of which month. Super customizable depending on how you want to schedule it. Let's go ahead and do week. So the cool thing about week is you can also select multiple days of the week at the same time. Let's go ahead and do Monday and Wednesday. And this is where you're gonna wanna, you know, change the number depending on how often, you know, every 2 weeks, every 3 weeks, every week, every 2 days, depending on how you want to, you know, customize the schedule. Let's go ahead and leave it by 2 weeks. And then you're gonna get to the part where it's gonna ask you, when would you like to display your tasks? So with our app, you have two options. You can have them display all at once, meaning that they're going to show up on the board automatically as soon as you click save based on the schedule you selected. Or you can use our automatic scheduling feature, which you have two options. In this case, you can have on the due date and custom. So what our automatic scheduling feature does basically is it auto creates those repetitive recurring tasks on your board based on the schedule that you have selected. So this is great for people that maybe want a more organized board and don't need all those tasks reflected on their board immediately all at once. So with our automatic scheduling feature, you have two options. Like I said, you can have on the due date, meaning that they will auto create themselves on your board on the due date in sense, you know, the date that you've selected, or you can use the custom option, which you can select, you know, how many specific days before the due date or how many weeks before the due date. So in this case, for example, I have selected it, 2 days before the due date, or if I go to week, it would be 2 weeks before the due date. So this is for people that maybe need a little bit more time before the task is due, or, you know, depending how their schedule works. Again, highly customizable. So let's go ahead and for this, demo show you first display them all now. It's important to note that the automatic scheduling feature creates those tasks at 12 midnight on the dot, depending obviously on your time zone. So if I were to select this, for example, I won't be able to show you on the board, but just keep in mind that they will create themselves at 12 midnight. So once you have selected how, you know, you want your task to display, you get to the ends option. So you can have it end, again, using our drop-down calendar on a specific date. So if I want it maybe until the 17th of April, or if you know you just, you know, this task is only supposed to repeat itself 3 or 4 times, you can do after specific number of repetitions. So in this case, I have items will repeat every 2 weeks on Monday and Wednesday 4 more times. Or for those that are going to use our automatic scheduling feature, you have the never option, which is going to show you obviously that this option is only available for scheduled tasks. And this option is great for those that maybe don't know when a scheduled task is supposed to end, meaning that it is an infinite recurring task and is subject to change when decided. But for now, when I set this up, it's going to be never. So that would be an option if you just want the recurring tasks automatic schedule to, keep functioning without having to intervene or, you don't have an end date. So let's go ahead and show you the example for display them all now. I'm going to use these after 4 repetitions. So it's always really useful to select, all your options and then after, just use a reference above what's in the blue text. So items will repeat every 2 weeks on Monday, Wednesday, 4 more times. That's what I wanted to select. So let's go ahead and click save. It's, instantaneous when it creates the task. So as you can see, it's showing me 4 items added to my board. And here they are reflected in chronological order based on the settings that I've selected. So now I'm going to show you how you can create a recurring task with a subitem. So our app works with subitems as well. So let's go ahead and open a subitem. As you can see, it looks exactly the same. Just a side note, it's important to install the app again within a subitem, just so it's saved within a subitem, and then from then on, you will automatically see the app for all subitems. So it's just a one-time thing. So let's go ahead and open it. And for this example, I'm going to show you how you can actually set up an automatic schedule and what it looks like after you set it up. So let's go ahead and select a date, the 6th of March. Repeats, once a month on the, let's go ahead and select the second Tuesday. And then we're gonna go and select custom, and I want my task to appear 1 day before the due date. And let's go ahead and select the never option in this case, because I don't know when it's going to end. It's an infinite task at the moment. So all you have to do is click save. Again, items will repeat every month on the second Tuesday with a never-ending schedule using our automatic scheduling. So let's go ahead and click save. So as you can see, it's showing me that the subitems have been scheduled. And here is actually the schedule box where I can see all my settings. And then this is essentially, if I wanted to change or delete the task, this is where I would go as well. So really useful to have, different options, whether you want the task to appear immediately or on a schedule. Now I'm going to show you how you can edit a recurring scheduled task or how you can delete a recurring scheduled task. So let's go ahead and open the app again. I'm going to set it up again just to show you what it looks like right after you're setting it. So let's go ahead and select once a day on the due date and ends after 6 repetitions. So items will repeat every day 6 more times on the automatic scheduling, meaning that in this case, it will appear on the due date. Let's go ahead and click save. So here again has appeared the setting box for my automatic scheduling. And you have 2 options here. So you can stop the repeating tasks or you can edit the repeating task. So to edit a repeating task, you just click on this pencil icon and it's going to show you that modifying a set of automated recurring tasks won't change any of the items already created, meaning any items that were already created on your board won't be affected. So changes will only impact events yet to be created. So I've read that. Let's go ahead and click OK. And as you can see, we're right back to where I started. Maybe I now have a specific day that I want that task to end on. So let's go ahead and select the 11th of April. Click save. And automatic scheduling updated, 57 items scheduled. To revert in the previous schedule, click undo. So that's how you would change it. And now any tasks that are to be created will be created based on this schedule. Now, let's say, I don't want this scheduled task anymore. I can delete it. All you're gonna have to do is click on the stop repeating task, little trash can icon. It's gonna show you that deleting a set of automated recurring tasks won't remove any items already created, only future scheduled tasks will be canceled, meaning that any items on my board already created will not be deleted, only future ones. So let's go ahead and click OK. And that's it. And the task has been deleted, so it will no longer create itself on my board. Now, to edit a recurring task item, it's the way you would edit or delete any other item. So if you click on one that's, for example, was created for the app, as you can see, it looks exactly the same. I can add in an update, a file, activity log. They actually all become native monday.com items, so one does not affect the other. And if I want to delete them, it's the same way I would delete any other item. So select the items I want to delete, then select delete, and they are off my board. So the great thing about our app is any item that it creates is a native monday.com item, so it would function like any other monday.com item on your board. So that's how you would edit and delete an item. So with our app, you can actually also select what you want to be considered a working day and a non-working day. So let me show you how you can, select those in the settings. So if you go to our app and you click on the top right, under settings, you're going to get this drop-down menu that's showing non-working days. And here you can select what you want the app to consider a working day or a non-working day. I don't work on Saturday and Sundays. I know some countries don't work on Fridays and they work on Sundays. So this is really useful, depending on honestly what days of the week you work on. So I have selected Saturday and Sunday, meaning that the app will never take into consideration Saturday and Sunday as a working day, meaning that it will never schedule a task on Saturday and Sunday. So what it will do instead is it will just jump to the working day that is considered a working day. In this case, it would be Monday, and that's when the task will be scheduled. So you really avoid having tasks created on days that you're not supposed to be working, or that task is not supposed to be showing up on that day. So very useful, and again, very customizable. And that's everything. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you found this video useful. If you would like to leave us any feedback or you have any questions on how to use the app, please feel free to contact us through our landing page, which you can access through our marketplace listing.